that was a wrong place to step.
Oh, it starts again, like I've never been away.
Off we go.
Feel it rising like the fire. Feel it running through my veins. Oh, it starts again, like I've never left this place. Like my prodigal return to an old familiar place. Oh,
good morning. Thunderbox is full. Sorry.
Overcast this morning, eh? But didn't rain, so that's good. Feel like I'm getting sick or something, I don't know. Hopefully it'll go away. All right, it's coffee time. Just keep feeding a little bit of sticks at a time. It'll go.
How?
I can't use, sorry. Kitchen. Good old fashioned bacon and eggs. Yum, yum, yum. Bacon. It's a heavily salted pre-cooked bacon. I call it bacon. I think everybody does. But it's awesome stuff. Your eggs are pretty much ready now. Your bacon isn't. Or your eggs down here. So the eggs and bacon are done, and Matt's gonna be ready to eat his breakfast soon, but now I gotta prepare the crumpets. And crumpets are awesome because what you do is you put them over fire, toast them up, make them nice and warm, and then you put butter on them. And let the butter ooze into all the little holes in the crumpet. Like a sponge, it sucks it up. And then you put peanut butter on top. And then it's yum, yum, yum time. Todd! I can't find my knife. I need your knife.
I've got a knife.
Holy cow. Look, man, there's some crumpets there. You need to put butter and peanut butter on them.
Is this knife gonna be big enough?
I think it's too big, man. I don't know if it's gonna fit in there.
We'll make it work.
Jesus Christ.
What? Just fill up the water.
We're running a little bit behind this morning, so we're just gonna pack up really quickly and get out of here, courtesy of the third coffee, so off we go.
We're really late now, but we're finally breaking camp, and we got two portages to go, and then we'll see you at Maple Creek. And the adventure begins. Going down Maple Creek. I haven't been here in about 15 years, so I have no idea what challenges lie ahead. I know when I was here 15 years ago, it was hell. And we were reading someone's recounting of coming through here 2 years ago in the book at the cabin, and they had a tough time too. But with these new boardwalks on the Portage and Tilly, I'm hopeful that maybe the crews came through here as well and cleaned it up a bit. But we don't know. We'll have to wait and see. So onwards. Onwards we go and into an adventure. Well, these alders have been trimmed, but they haven't been freshly trimmed. So I don't know. Could be beaver. That's not beaver. That's somebody coming in with a knife. Could be crews of the chainsaw. I don't know. I don't know. I honestly don't know. I don't know if they cut it down further. They just cut it like this, but I mean, a beaver is not gonna reach up here and up here. So this was cut by a human hand. And it wasn't chewed on by a moose. Oh. So far, so good, but I mean, we've only been going for 2 or 3 minutes now. Well, the water's deep, that's handy, but it was kind of deep at this part of the creek when I came through 15 years ago. It was further up the creek, it was quite shallow. And again, another nice day of weather. It's cooler. The humidity is gone, it's starting to feel like fall, but it's sunny, still no rain, so yay. Oh, there's a leech on my paddle. Get him off! Ah! there's another beaver lodge here on Maple Creek. We've had a couple dams we've crossed. It's all going downstream now, so we're going down the dams instead of having to go up them. Since North Raven Lake, we've been going downhill, and we'll continue going downhill all the way to Kayak. So we're gonna be basically taking the Maple Creek watershed right down to Kayak. And this is part of Maple Creek as being both very beautiful and very hellish to get through. But so far, it's been a dream. Those alders back there were no accident; they were trimmed. And whoever did that, thank you very, very much. It sucks when your bow partner is too busy filming the paddle. Ugh. nowhere near the 245 portage. I don't know what this portage is here. It says 245. Maybe I gotta quit this program again and relaunch it. This is showing us further upstream that we're not at that portage, but we did just cross a logging road, which was right there. So, I mean, you mean this portage is down here? I don't know, I don't understand. I think maybe somebody made a mistake on this map, or this is another portage that's not on the map. Oh, well, we'll find out. In any case, we're at the 245 meter portage, and we made it through the alders so far, and they were cut. There were some fresh cuts there. It looked like they were cut this spring. So, woohoo, we've had an easy go of it. We took our time, but I'm happy about that. So let's get this portage over with, and then we can start paddling our way up to Arabla Lake. Apple, cranberries, cashews, almonds, and chocolate M&Ms and peanut butter M&Ms. So, lots of fat and some protein in there. And I like the dried apple. Oh, look, I got some M&Ms, multicolored dried apple. Yum, yum, yum. Thank you. So we just left the 245 meter portage, and I got a good feeling, confidence is high, that that there's an error on Jeff's map, the last version of his map, map 5, and that we actually aren't in trouble after all, and things are going to be rosy. But I don't know, the alders are creeping in on us again. But that last section was really good, and the portage had been recently cut. So, and I can see that from that person's report of 2 years ago, all the blowdowns they were talking about, it really would have been a nasty portage to do. There was quite a few blowdowns on it. So, I'm hoping pretty soon along here we'll pass by the 695 meter portage of Scoose Lake, and then I'll know that there in fact is an error with the map. I just figure maybe it was bad data that Jeff collected and incorporated in the map. So, you know, he relies on a lot of people to give him data to make his map accurate, and occasionally that happens. People make mistakes. Machines make mistakes because people program them incorrectly. So I think that's what it is. At least I hope that's what it is, because I don't want to do another 245 and then a 90 and then a 660 and then a 170 to get to our destination of Maple Lake. But, oh dear Matt, I think you're gonna have to put the camera down. It's getting kind of tight. Here come the alders. Fresh beaver chew in there. There's an active beaver in this area. That's probably the highest dam we've seen so far on this trip. Wow. And no wonder why it looks so flooded in here, eh? Hey, get a picture of this. Wait, get a picture of it. Woo-hoo! Quite the height difference, eh? There you go. Okay, time to get out. I think this is where it gets bad, guys. I can't. Well, that was the wrong place to step. Okay, I'm going through the alders here, looking for a creek. Yeah, this is it here, man. We gotta come this way. Holy cow. It has turned into hell. Oh my God, this is bad. Holy jeez. Yeah, this is not fun. I just wish I was on Maple Lake right now. Hell. Ugh. I think this is where I got leeches on me. I vaguely remember this. Stupid alder. Ugh. There's a big rock here, and there's one there. I can't see anything, but I can feel it. Oh, there's nothing there. I think there's another rock up there. Jesus. Oh, come on. All right, well, I'm going for a swim. Oh, whoa. Whoa. Okay, it's getting really deep here, so I think I might be safe to jump back in. Oh, come on. There's another rock right here. Okay. That's a very good sign. I like that sign. We're not going that way, but it's a good checkpoint for us. It means that the rest of the creek, the rest of the way, for the rest of our journey down to Kiosk, oh, stupid dam, it's supposed to be good. It's another dam. But yeah, it's gonna be open water. The alders should be done with. That hell is done, thank God. I was really starting to get stressed about it, so. Good, we're on our way to better waters, so let's get out of here. Let's keep going. Quest for Maple Lake. Nice. Now we're moving. It's a 90 meter portage. You do this, you got more paddling on Maple Creek, and this is where it's really gonna open up. The only time I was on here, I saw a really nice bull moose on here. And then we got the 660 into Arabla, and then a nice long paddle up Arabla Lake, and then 170 meter into Maple, and hopefully we'll score my campsite. Okay, so we got the 90 meter portage done, and now we're in a part of Maple Creek where it just starts to open up and it gets really gorgeous. So we're on our way to the 660 meter portage to Arabla, get that done, and then we'll paddle up Arabla to the last portage of the day into Maple. And I'm hoping to get there by 6. I think it was going to be a long day, but oh well, a little longer than I expected. But all that creek madness is behind us, so I'm quite happy. Successful day so far. And we're on our way again. Last big portage of this day. And nice paddle up the lake and then the shorty in the Maple. So let's just land and get her done. Goodbye, Upper Maple Creek. Bye. Thank you. Come again.
Wow.
Hello. We're on Arabla. We're all in very good spirits. We put all the nasty stuff behind us, and we're just kind of paddled up beautiful Arabla Lake to the last short portage of the day, and then we'll be in the Maple. Last portage of the day. Yeah, this is new bridge. You must have put it in with the last few years. Used to be an older, much older wooden bridge here. I guess they plan to do a lot more logging in the coming seasons, coming years. Oh well. pretty little falls down there. Hand saucer. Thank you. Sometimes when you're close to your next destination campsite, there's a portage nearby. It's always good to pick along the trail and look for firewood. It's a good way to get really good wood in a hurry with minimum effort. We're here. I'm home. My campsite on Maple Lake. It's free. Yay! Woohoo! Yeah! About time. It's late. Let's get up there. Woohoo! Oh, there's people chopping down trees. Unbelievable. See, this is what I don't like. This chopping down trees. Looks like it was, I don't know if it was alive or not, but you know, come on. Just go to shore and get your firewood over there. Anyways, we brought some of our own firewood, and there is some wood here. But yeah, this is a. I like this site. There's a hell of a lot better sites than this in the park, but I love this. Got great swimming, great sunset. Moose over there, deer sometimes. Saw my first bear on this lake. It's really nice. You get sunrises too. Nice sunny day, you can lay out here in the rocks or hang a hammock. It's a really lazy, rocky, piney site. I love it. This is awesome. Used to be an amazing spot back there, like in a grove of hemlocks or white pines, but they all got blown over in a storm like many years ago. So, but yeah, love this site, man. A lot of memories here. And there's a devil's fork tree. See, it's got three prongs. It's still there. Thank you. Okay, so we got some crackers and a lovely map of Maple Lake. We are right here, right now. I like this lake because it's like two lakes in one. It's not teardrop shaped and it's not necessarily round. It has a round portion at the bottom and a teardrop shape at the top. So it's like two lakes in one. And there's beaches all over the place. But there's only one campsite that has a beach. It's way over here. But all the other ones don't. But it's great for swimming. You just paddle to the beach, go for a swim, and paddle back to your campsite. It's really nice. So I think it's a pretty lake. A lot of other lakes that are probably much more prettier than this one, but I like it, and I like the paddle down Maple Creek. It's beautiful paddling. I've always seen moose in there. I think the only time I've ever been through there and I didn't see moose was a short solo trip, but every other time I have seen moose, and we haven't seen a single moose this trip, so it would be nice to see one tomorrow. Anyways, I gotta get started on the snacks. Meats. Cheeses. Open up some of this cheese now. Extra old maple wood smoked. And we had apple wood? Now we got maple wood. So I got a little bit of some gypsy salami here. Maybe it's time for your knife. You got your knife? You want to chop up some salami?
I think I might have a knife.
Okay.
I'll go get it.
All right. Dinner time, Maple Lake, dark, and we've got homemade chili that I made back home last month. Well, it's a bit of a process at home, but like when you bring it out to the park, it's really simple. All you have to do is pour it in the pot, heat up, boil some water, or you can use cold water, but it seems to take longer if you use cold, and let it rehydrate, and then I heat it up and simmer it for a little bit and serve, and that's it.
Is it hard to
while we're eating jujubes because they're yummy. I'm retired. Been a really long day. Almost 9 hours to get to Maple Lake. Maple Creek, or the upper portion of Maple Creek. Was hell for a little bit, and it surprised me. I thought we had missed all the bad alders, but in waterways, but we hadn't. We ran into it unexpectedly. Also, too, I realized that there was an error in the latest version of Jeff's map with respect to the 245 meter portage. And I don't know, these jujus are good.
Oh, we're getting smoked out.
And we fought our way down that creek. And then we made it to Arabla. And had a beautiful paddle up the lake. And Todd, who was soloing behind us, heard wolves on the lake just as he hit the portage in the maple. We didn't hear him because we were at the end of the portage, and with the sound of the waterfall It drowned out any hopes of us of hearing the wolves. So I'm very tired. It's been a long day. It's been a long week. It's been a good week. We haven't seen anybody for 3 days now. So that's nice. There was nobody in Arabla. I don't think there's anybody else on Mabel Lake. It's a great time to be up here.
Smoke is too much.
It's getting cold tonight. It's getting really cold, so.
Us too.
Oh, you're a dude. Thanks, man. And probably just gonna go to bed soon. It's been a long day. And, tripped through some beautiful forest there. I was really surprised to see that portage from Tilly Lake down to Maple Creek in such good repair. Like, there were brand new boardwalks on there. Blowdowns have been removed, and it looks like the blowdowns on Maple Creek were removed either last year or the year before. Good job to the crews that go in there. You guys are much appreciated, and thank you. Oh, I think you saved us a lot of trouble. I can't imagine if it went through there. It was covered with blowdowns, it'd be really bad right now. You'd probably still be there.
Hey, do you know any ghost stories?
No.
Have you ever had any, like, encounters? Strange things?
No. Look, just the one I told you about on 1 Mile Lake.
I don't know if you told me.
That was the one with the thunderbox closing all on its own, when there was no one else on the lake. You sure I didn't tell you that one?
No.
I was camping on a lake all by myself. It's a small lake. It's on the Maple Creek, much further up than where we were. And there's three campsites in the lake, and I took the middle one, and there was nobody else in the lake. That was a 20-day solo trip I did. And I'm just trying to think. That was like, let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, maybe night 6 or night 7 of the trip. Anyways, I went to bed, and something went plop on the tent and was skittling about up and down, and it was kind of freaking me out. Oh, there's loons. Yeah, they're under the lake. And I hit the tent and it went away, so I figured it was a mouse or something. And then, sound awesome so far away. Then I heard what I imagined was a bear with big jaws and claws coming for me, crashing through the forest. And what it was is I was hearing the crown of a tree come down and hit other trees as it was falling down. A tree was falling in the forest. It was my first time I'd heard one fall. I was by myself, and I was kind of freaking out about it. So then, I rolled over and laughed at myself. Oh, you're being silly, you know, letting everything get the best of you and nature and all that. Now the noises become magnified at night. So I rolled over and tried to go to sleep. And then the most unnerving noise I ever heard happened. The clear, distinct sound of a thunderbox lid slamming shut. And I jumped up. I'm like, I can't take this anymore. I ran out, stoked up the fire, and had a couple drinks of whiskey. And I'm like, everything's going to be okay. I was really freaking out. To this day, I have no explanation except maybe I'm thinking maybe a bear was nearby, like at one of the other sites. And maybe somebody had dropped food in the thunderbox before they left. Some people put weird objects in there. I don't know why, they just do. And maybe it attracted a bear, and the bear got in there with his nose and lifted it up and was trying to smell, and then when he was done, the lid slammed shut. I don't know. That's my theory anyways. But that really scared the pants off of me.
I didn't believe in ghosts, but that kind of freaked me out. So I had a couple of drinks, calmed down, sat around the fire for a bit longer. When I felt comfortable, I went back to bed and went to sleep. And the next day, I got the hell out of there. That was the day I traveled from One Mile Lake to this side of Maple Lake, and it took me 10 hours solo. So I traveled further along the creek than we did, and it took us almost 9 hours. Mind you, I was tripling in soloing, which I'll never do again.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I single carry now, but, you know, it was... Is your foot on fire? Oh no. Hello.
I don't care, man.
Your foot is smoking.
Get it warm.
The log is smoking. But yeah, that was a real tough trip. That was like very early on in my camping days, and I didn't know any better. So, yeah, don't ever triple portage. It's the stupidest thing you could ever do. Yeah, that's it, pretty much. No other scary things.
That is scary, though. That's my main concern when I think about, as every day I'm out there paddling, you know, behind you guys, I end up with a lot of time to myself, and like,
yeah,
a lot of the times I'm thinking about, like, if I was alone, how I'd be handling it,
how you'd react to
yeah.
it.
Yeah. And I think I would love it, except for that would be a hard one for me, getting over that, like, weird sounds or you know, nighttime.
Well, that's the thing. You come out here, you're going to hear a lot of things you never heard before in your life, right? Because you just don't get them in an urban environment. So it's all new, and until you get used to them, it's going to be unsettling at first, especially if it's a startling noise.
Right.
Right?
Yeah, like a tree falling. Like, we heard one the other night crash in the water, which was awesome.
Yeah.
But if I was by myself and I never heard that before, I'd be freaking out.
Yeah, was that a bear pushing over a tree or what? You know, it's like, hey, what's going on?
The thing is, it's not animals that... But I'm not worried about a bear or wolves coming around. It's more just my imagination gets the better of me, you know?
Yeah, I think that's human nature, though. That's just fear built in, right? Your imagination runs a little wild.
But I definitely can understand your... personal affection for this island. It's amazing.
It's nice, eh? Nice sunset. And like I were talking about earlier, there's something about the acoustics on this lake that just make it, I don't know, it's just like the sound just reverberates really well on this lake. It's almost like a dream. So. But yeah, so tomorrow... we've got 6 portages as we trip down Maple Creek and into Kiosk, and we're going to stay the night on Kiosk in the interior there on the lake, and then we drive out early tomorrow morning, and then we'll not tomorrow morning, the next morning, and then we'll be driving over to Rain Lake Access and going into McCraney for a couple of nights for a very special trip. So tomorrow is going to be it's not going to be another busy day, but we're not going to run into the problems on the creek like we did today, because this part of Maple Creek below Maple Lake and the Kiosk is actually quite nice. It's lovely to paddle, especially the last stretch before the last portage. It's quite a long stretch between portages, and it's one of my favorite creeks, sections of a creek, and favorite creek to paddle in the whole park. So I'm looking forward to it, and I don't know, I'm hoping maybe the creek will be with us and maybe share a little bit of secrets, and maybe a moose will show up or something. That would be really nice. That's all I really got to say about tonight. I'm just ready for bed. I want to drink some water and just throw my long johns on and go to sleep.
You want to give us one more wolf howl before we go to bed and see if... You know what? If that sound, like, so right as it happened, I stopped. I couldn't believe it was happening. It's the first sound I've heard here.
Yeah.
Right? It's so quiet here. It's, It's almost deafening. Like, it's, the quiet is like...
Yeah, the silence is deafening.
You can hear your blood pumping in your ears. And so I started hearing these wolves, and it took me a minute. It took a moment to register. And then I was like, and you guys weren't around. I grabbed my camera, and my battery's been like almost dead for the last few hours of the day. And there was... I just hit record, and I started recording, and I was trying to be as quiet as I can. And then after about 2 minutes, they stopped, and my camera battery died. And we're going to listen to it and hope that the sound recorded and that we can salvage it.
Yeah, that would be nice.
And if it did record, our editors will be putting it in the background right now. It would sound something like this. And if it didn't work, then we just look weird.
Yeah.
You gonna hit the sack?
Well, where's that piece of birch bark that we pulled out?
It's right there.
Right over there. Look at what we found on a dead birch tree today on the Arapla Lake portage.
You might want to back the camera up.
It's almost broken in half, but it's like one huge piece of birch bark. It's like beautiful. So we're going to leave it here at the campsite for the next person to enjoy, but it's really nice. I mean, and it's thick too. This is the kind of stuff that First Nations used to use to build their canoes here in Ontario. And I think it's really awesome. Using, you know, the skin of a tree to build a craft that could take you to really amazing places throughout this province. I thought that was really neat. That's it for tonight. I got hit the hay. I'm really tired. Really, really tired. Pump some water and go to bed. Good night.
Now it's time to say good night. Good night. Sleep tight.
I got canoes in my hand and I don't know.
Paddles in my hand and I don't know. You're my little moose poop. You don't know what I got.
Wow!
Did you get the extension?
No!
No!
Shooting a nice shot of the fire. Luckily, we just didn't go up in flames right now.
I think we can say the chili works.
Yeah, I'll say. I'm glad I'm not sleeping the same time as you. Did you see a dock spider on the wall here? The wall face as you paddle by?
No.
There's a big dock spider there.
Okay, can I tell you a good dock spider story?
Yeah.
I have many. I do. I have a lot. But here's just one. And this is in... we have them in Chelsea as well, because we live by the river.
Yeah.
So... I get a call at work, and I'm chatting with my wife, and all of a sudden, she's got a friend staying with us for the week, and all of a sudden, just mayhem, just like screaming and shouting over the phone. I was like, oh my God, and then I was like, I was imagining like someone broke in or something bad happened, and I was like, is everything okay? And she's like, yeah, there's a spider, it's big, it's a big spider. And I was like, oh my God, like, okay, like you scared me. Like, I'm afraid of spiders too, but that was a little overkill. And she's like, it's okay, Sarah put a bowl on it. I was like, okay, like, I'll talk to you later, I'll see you when I get home. And then at the end of the day, I go home, and there, I walk in and say hello, and Jane's like, you know, the spider is still downstairs if you want to go deal with that. I was like, she knows I hate spiders, but I guess, you know, whatever. I'm the man, so it's my job. So I was like, oh, like, okay. And I looked down at the bottom of the basement stairs, and there's like those little like translucent, like colored IKEA bowls upside down. So I go downstairs, I'm looking at it, and I'm like, oh, I can't really see through it. I put a piece of paper underneath to go take it outside. And I was like, oh God, no, I could, like, it's gonna like, I'm gonna feel it on my hand through the paper. So I went and found like something a little bit thicker and like slid it underneath, and then I'm taking it up, and my son's with me. And then we get to the front door, we're going out, and I just hear like squealing. They're like, ah, behind me. I was like, what? And they're like, you can see it through the bowl, it's huge. And I look through the bowl, I was like, oh God, it's so big. And then so we go outside. And I put it down, and my son's with me. And not a good example, because I'm like teaching him to be afraid of spiders, which he is. And I like kick the bowl over and like run away really quickly. And then we get a look at the spider, and I'm not even exaggerating. This thing was like the size of my fist. Mm. And I was like, oh God, it like flipped over and it started crawling. And I realized like they get pretty big, but it was like thick. Mm. And I'd seen this before. It was pregnant.
Oh, okay.
And so we're like, wow, like that's, you know, creepy. Like we were watching it crawl away to make sure it didn't.
You took it out of the house before, you know.
And this is what I was thinking. I was like, oh my God, like thank God you found it. Thank God you caught it. Thank God we took it outside. Because that would have been
hundreds. Yeah.
Of spiders, dog spiders in my house. Yeah, that's good. Which would have been my personal nightmare.
Yeah.
Yeah. And just then, this has nothing to do with spiders, a buck, a deer, three deer come running out of the woods onto our road.
Oh, yeah?
And the females are paying no attention, and the buck just, like, looks up at me at Tobin. And it was this far, like, it was, like, I don't know, maybe, like, 100 meters.
Yeah.
And it just goes like this. Staring at us.
Yeah.
And I was like, Tobin, let's go inside. I've never seen that before.
Huh. What do you think he was? Holy acrobatic work.
That's good chili work.
Glad you like that. Oh my God. Think that deer was trying to tell you something? Don't fart in front of my girls.
He's a mados.
Yeah. Oh, jeez.